Hey guys, today we're going to be performing affinity chromatography. The purpose of affinity chromatography is to purify a target protein from a cell lysate, and today we're going to be using a selective glutathione column. In this experiment, we're going to be purifying GST Campari. And so the basic setup for an affinity chromatography is first, and one of the very most important things is to think about your resin. The resin is typically formed between three different categories, one being the matrix, the spacer, and the ligand that's actually going to bind to your
protein.
And so whenever you finally have prepped your affinity chromatography column, you're going to have your resin on the sides, and that they're going to be capturing GST Campari because of the glutathione that we have. But we also have to remember that as this is a cell lysate, you're going to be having a bunch of different non-competitive and non-binding proteins. And so the purpose is that we're going to be using gravity in order to have a slow enough rate that as we're flowing through our cell lysate, we can capture our GST Campari, and then we can wash it and elute it, and then in the end, in our elution fractions, we ideally will have just GST Campari.
Before purification of the protein, the arabinose-induced PDES-15 Campari expression vectors were lysed and homogenized to release cellular components. After the step was completed, the bacterial solution was sonicated and centrifuged. Sonication, which serves to separate cellular proteins and lipids, was performed to further disrupt the cell and shear any DNA present. Centrifugation was then used to separate the insoluble debris from the solution so that these debris do not slow down the protein movement through the column.
Add 3 milliliters of brine wash buffer with 10 millimolar EGTA. Diluting the sample will increase the sample binding to the column. EGTA will bind to any present calcium that could otherwise bind to GST Campari. Assemble the chromatography column. Invert the GST bind resin to mix, and add the slurry to the column. Open the stopcock to allow the resin buffer to drip until it reaches just above the top of the affinity resin. Add the bind wash buffer. Allow the buffer to drip until it reaches the top of the resin bed. Add the previously made cell lysate. Allow it to flow through at a slow rate. This enables you to have an efficient GST Campari binding to the affinity resin. Add this flow through again to collect any GST Campari that was not previously bound to the affinity resin. Remove a 10 microliter aliquot for SDS page analysis. Add 10 microliters of 2-fold SDS page sample buffer to the aliquot taken. Collect 50 microliters for fluorescence analysis. Label 6 collection tubes for each wash fraction. Add 5 milliliters bind wash buffer to wash out non-essential proteins in the column. The flow through from this step will be collected in fractions. The first fraction will contain the greatest concentration of protein. There will be decreasing amounts of protein in each subsequent fraction.
For the last wash, add 5 milliliters bind wash buffer to remove any non-GST proteins left behind. Collect a 10 microliter aliquot from the last wash for fluorescence analysis. Next, add an elution buffer containing a high concentration of reduced glutathione. This enables you to compete for binding with GST Campari on their glutathione resin. This will cause GST Campari to dissociate from the column and flow through. The flow through will then be collected in 6 elution fractions. Store fractions for future use or fluorescence analysis. View under the UV transilluminator to see the different concentrations of Campari.